Hello again, Pastor Deborah here, and this is another episode, another part of The Multitudes, Volume 2. This is episode part number 19. We left off in part 18 and having you to look at the differences, to look at yourself, to see if your spirit, your soul, are of the flesh, carnal nature, in which it does not please God, or are you of a spiritual nature, one with the Holy Spirit living on the inside of you, and He is growing and maturing you, and your acts and your thoughts and your imaginations are changing from the natural, carnal, flesh world of below the kingdom of heaven, back into the high place, back into the rightful place that you are to be thinking. So let's pick up here with episode 19. But also know that even a born-again spiritual person and his spiritual heart and mind that is saved, reconnected, back, redeemed, born again from eternal death, from the eternal separation from God and His truth and light, from His kingdom of heaven, can still think and live and act and be still one of a carnal flesh nature through his thoughts and feelings and knowledge, and still have his soul as the head, as the king, the ruler of the spirit and the physical body, until a divorce, a separation occurs between the spirit and the soul, until a spiritual circumcision is done, according to Hebrews 4:12. Verse 12 says, "For the word of God is quick. It's alive and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the spiritually dividing asunder, apart from each other, of soul and spirit, and of the joints and the marrow, all that holds the soul and the spirit together as one, married, conjoined, and is a spiritual discerner of the spiritual thoughts and intents of the spiritual heart and mind. But with proper spiritual shepherding, mothering, parenting, by a true spiritual shepherd of the spiritual heart and mind and soul, a spiritual man, a newborn baby, can be led and guided, will have to be rebuked and corrected in its newly born-again life. The spiritual child of the Heavenly Father will need a lot of help, a lot of teaching and guiding. The spiritual child will begin to build and develop on a solid foundation of agape love, and will slowly develop and mature and become the new creature in Christ, the very Word of God itself, that the Heavenly Father has already prophetically spoken about, decreed and declared by law to be, and for the new spiritual heart and mind and soul to recognize and to think that the old man of the flesh is dead, and it died on the cross, and begins to put on the new spiritual identity of the new man, and thus no longer to fulfill the lust of the flesh. More about this is written in another book. It called 1 + 1 = 1. 2 become 1. So how does the darkened spiritual child get this light, this truth and knowledge of God and His kingdom of heaven? He sent a spiritual shepherd, a mother, a pastor, a teacher in His full authority and dominion of His kingdom of heaven, as His spiritual ambassador, an apostle, a sent one, representing and bringing His greatest gift, agape love, to reattach His precious little spiritual ones back to Himself, to God, the Heavenly Father. So through accepting this spiritual shepherd, this king, this ambassador, this mother, this pastor, one will be spiritually attached, reattached to this your unknown and unseen spiritual father and mother, God the Most High and agape love. For this shepherd brings the word of God, The truth brings the mediator, the Christ, the very person named Jesus, to you, the one who went to the cross and laid down his life for you. He is the reconnection. He is the bond of love that this shepherd brings to you for you to reattach to and be born again. Also, this agape love in this true spiritual shepherd of humanity's spirit and soul will spiritually destroy the spiritual bonds to the darkness and ignorance and its king, Satan, and its kingdom of darkness, and its mothers, and its shepherds, and its pastors, and its vessels of darkness and ignorance and bondage of control and slavery. For through the power of agape love, this gift of Christ Jesus, this Christ Jesus is the bondage breaker. His words of spirit and life, they break the matrix. They unplug you. They are the red pill. They are the ones that bring you out. And this shepherd brings this pill to you in the matrix, in the darkness and ignorance, for you to be unplugged and be born again. The Heavenly Father will spiritually reach out and touch you himself through this chosen and pure shepherd of spiritual hearts and minds and souls. The Heavenly Father will speak to you, his spiritual children, himself, through the voice, through written words, through her spirit itself, and through her very physical hands, as he was in his Son, Christ Jesus, on earth. The two of them, the Father and the Son, will reach out to you through the vessel of this ambassador. For they are the gift. They are the bondage breaker. They are who you need to be reconnected to. When one receives this spiritual shepherd of agape love and the spiritual hearts and minds and souls of humanity, one receives the Heavenly Father himself and his agape love. Then over time and with much agape love and nurturing and teaching, support and comfort, protection and deliverance, one will become one with the Heavenly Father in and through the Holy Spirit. So I, the Most High God, the Heavenly Father, have sent to you my greatest gift I have. All that you need is me, agape love. For I desire to be one with you, one spiritual family. Your father and mother want you back so very much. Please hurry home to us. Come and see. Come and taste. Come and be touched by me and my agape love. I have kept the lights on for you. I made a way when there was no way. I have provided all you need for the trip. Everyone is waiting for you to arrive. The angels are waiting to meet you and serve you. All those who have already come home are also waiting to meet you. Please hurry home to me, dear one, your Heavenly Father. Dear precious child, the Heavenly Father and I want to spiritually tell you how much you are loved with a love unknown to you, agape love. You are so spiritually precious to the both of us, and there is no spiritual distance too great for the two of us to spiritually travel, to spiritually reach you in the spiritual darkness. The Heavenly Father wants to spiritually invite you to come and see a great wonder you have never seen or experienced before, the Garden of Eden. For the Heavenly Father is spiritually pouring out his great, powerful, and majestic agape love into billions and billions and billions of precious ones such as you. So, sweetie, come and see. There is no physical travel required, and you don't have to know the way. The Holy Spirit does. So, honey, come and see agape love in the Garden of Eden at work. Please listen to a precious young lady's heart cry to go to a land where there's no trouble. Over the Rainbow, 1939, sung by Judy Garland, The Wizard of Oz, written by E. Harburg, and Harold Arden. Judy Garland lyrics are property and copyright of their owners, taken from the movie The Wizard of Oz, 1939. Auntie Anne was speaking to Dorothy. Find yourself a place where there isn't any trouble. Dorothy speaking to herself and her dog Toto. A place where there isn't any trouble? Do you suppose that there is such a place, Toto? There must be. It isn't a place you can get to by a boat or a train. It is far away, behind the moon, beyond the rain. Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby. Somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue, and dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops, away above the chimney top. That's where you'll find me, somewhere over the rainbow. Bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh why can't I? If happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rainbow, why, oh why can't I? Such a heart cry from a young girl from the Wizard of Oz. For we all cry and sing in our heart the same song, wanting to fly somewhere where our troubles melt like lemon drops. And that is what happens when you get reconnected and you get reborn again. And the spirit of life and truth of the Father himself comes into your spirit. And a spiritual circumcision occurs between the spirit and the soul. And now the spirit, the one that will live on in eternity, that will fly over the rainbow, that one, the forever person, will begin to grow again, be renewed, and learn and grow, and become all it was decreed and prophesied to become, a king on earth in the kingdom of heaven, and bringing the influence and the power and the majesty of the kingdom of God into the earth to help other people, to run and control and govern the whole world, the globe, all of nature and resources, and to be a mighty shepherd, pastor, king, and manager and controller of the earth for his Father, the King of the Kingdom of Heaven. So this ends Volume 2 of The Multitude. We will have another volume of The Multitude, Volume 3. So continue on. Enjoy this one. This ends Part 19. Look forward to you listening to another volume, Volume 3, The Multitudes. Love always and forever, Pastor Deborah. Thank you for listening and watching this video. It is an honor and a pleasure to have you stopped by today and watch. This is Pastor Deborah, and I hope you come again and watch many, many more videos and learn and grow spiritually and hear how she has helped people spiritually, the Lord's way, for many, many years. Come again, watch another one, and we welcome you to be a subscriber to the channel, to make comments, and if you wish to contact Pastor Deborah, please email her at her email address for the ministry at Pastor Deborah at agapeloveishere.org. You can also see these videos on Twitter and on the website in the many different sections that they are put into. Enjoy, and it was once again an honor to have you watch and listen. Thank you, and come again to another video of Agape Love, Love is Here Ministries, a ministry of helping people the Lord's way that Pastor Deborah has been doing for many, many years. Love always and forever, Pastor Deborah.